Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at how you can monitor your apps in iOS 8. So you can monitor your apps in many different ways. For instance, for battery usage, for storage, and also which apps they can communicate with and which information they have access to. So for instance, let's go to Settings, and then under Settings, General, and under General, Usage, and then tap battery usage there at the top. And you're going to get a list there of all the different apps that you're using and the percentage of battery that they're using. Now keep in mind, you got to measure this against a few things. First of all, if an app should be using more battery, then don't be alarmed if it is. For instance, if you had your phone plugged in, then unplugged it, and then took an hour-long run using an app that tracked you via GPS, then you would expect that to take the lion's share of battery usage. If it takes 90% of your battery usage, well, that makes sense. You weren't using any other apps, and of course, using GPS is going to use a lot of power. On the other hand, if you notice that a game that you only played for 10 minutes out of a whole day of use is using 40% battery power, well, that's a lot of battery power for just 10 minutes out of an entire day. So keep that in mind as you look through this list, and maybe don't make any quick judgments based on one look, but maybe look on several consecutive days to see which apps are using the most power. So next, let's go up a level and then go under Storage and tap on Manage Storage. And here you'll get a list of your apps and how much storage space they're using. Now if you tap on them, you get a bit of a breakdown, but usually not too much. For instance, you just get documents and data. So I can see only very little documents data is being used, so most of that is actually for the size of the app itself. However, some other things give you some more details. Under Photos and Camera gives you a bit of a breakdown there. I can see most of the space there is being used by my photo library. And if you go to even more apps, apps that actually have bits of media attached to them, like for instance the podcast app, I can actually look at some of the video podcasts I've got, and not only can I see how much space they're taking up, I only have this wand right here, but I can actually swipe right to left and delete the content right from the Settings app here. I don't have to go into the individual app itself. The Videos app does a similar thing as well. So next, at the top level here in Settings, let's look at Privacy. And under Privacy, you've got a list of all sorts of data that you can tap on and see which apps have access to them. So I can see that, for instance, several apps here have asked for access to my contacts and I've granted it. Usually when you first run an app, it does this. I can revoke that access here. Or if I said no, here's where I could fix that. Sometimes you run into that if you say, no, I don't want to have this app to have access to my contacts, and then you find out now the app doesn't work quite as you expected and you want to give it access, this is where you can do it. And you have various things here like which apps have access to your photos, your camera, all sorts of different information. So you can go in, and also you can look across for even third-party apps like Facebook and Twitter sometimes to see which ones have access to that. Under Location Services, you can see which apps have access to location services and also some information about that. So if you look at all those arrows there, a key for those is at the very bottom here, and it tells you that a solid purple arrow means it recently used your location. A gray one means that it's used it in the last 24 hours. And a hollow arrow uses geofence, which is when you're in a small area like a ballpark or a store, it will kind of know that you're in the store or perhaps even where you are in the store. So you can kind of get an idea here. You can also give and revoke access for apps for when it has location access here. And the last way I'm going to show you to monitor your apps is going to notifications. And this tells you which apps can pop up notifications on your screen and how they can do so. So for instance, if we just go into phone here, we can see how notifications appear, whether they're not there at all, they're banners or alerts. We can see if the icon itself can have that number next to it, how many are shown in Notification Center, like the last five, that kind of thing. So this is very useful, especially if you play a lot of games. You can go in and find that game that keeps notifying you of something and you don't really want it to bother you, and you can turn off notifications or tone them down as well, especially the sounds. You can, for a lot of these, turn off sounds so that perhaps a notification does pop up but it doesn't actually make your phone buzz or make an audible sound when something happens. So you want to go through these and kind of monitor your apps. Notice that if you turn off notifications completely, then the app jumps down to this Do Not Include section here at the bottom, which means there are no notification settings for it. So only things where you actually have notifications turned on in some way are here at the top. I have a lot of those game setter numbers there next to the icon, so I want to turn that off, and now I won't see that number there every time I look at the icon on the home screen. And one last way I'm going to show you to monitor your apps is by going into the App Store and then tapping Update to the bottom right hand corner. And here you'll see your updates. If you have everything set to defaults, it's going to automatically update apps, which is fine, and you can actually see the information about each of the app updates here. If you have that turned off, then you would actually use this to manually update each app. So what's great here is I can tap on one of these and see what's new in those versions. And you have quite a big history here of these. So that's great when you notice something's changed in an app, or you notice that there's a blue dot next to an app. You can now see what has changed.